While considering a corrigenda to the draft budget estimates for the 2023-2024 financial year, MPs raised eyebrows when it came to allocation of 244 billion shillings to the central bank towards reducing government liabilities with the bank. MPs questioned how the government accrued a debt with the Bank of Uganda to that magnitude.
About 1 trillion, I think 250 billion, will go to settle the indebtedness at the central bank. Then there is also another additional 250 billion, which was already presented in the draft estimate.
Now they are adding 250. The question that we want to know is the extent of our liability to Bank of Uganda. Okay.
They were joined by the chairperson, Patrick Opolot Isiagi, the MP of Kachumbala, and demanded an explanation about the type of liabilities government owes to Bank of Uganda, arguing that short of a coherent explanation, this transaction relates to fraud.
So you have to really explain if it's not just a mismanagement taking place. There are supposed to be no liability with the Bank of Uganda when the year closes.
The Butambala County MP, Mwanga Chivumbi, pointed out that it is prudent to establish the magnitude of this liability and whether the country's reserves with Bank of Uganda are still intact.
Is the extent of our reserves with the Bank of Uganda, are they as they were, or they have encroached on the reserves of Bank of Uganda? We are in a peculiar situation. The other one is our drawing rights in IMF.
Percent, yes. When, for what?
For what?
Because the year should close when there is no debt. So if there is a liability, then it should be in form of a loan.
MPs claim that the government has been borrowing from the country's reserve at leisure. However, the State Minister for Finance in charge of general duties, Henry Musasizi, who was appearing before the Committee on Budget to justify the corrigenda to the budget, clarified that they do not borrow from the central bank as alleged by the budget committee, but the central bank extends advances to the government.
Bank of Uganda gives us advance. Specifically at the beginning of the financial year, when we have not collected revenue to kickstart the activities in July, we normally get an advance from Bank of Uganda to the tune of the law allows us up 10%.
Currently, the government owes Bank of Uganda 3 trillion shillings in liabilities, but only 1.2 trillion shillings has been allocated in the 2023-2024 financial year budget. The committee resolved to summon the Bank of Uganda officials on Monday next week to establish the status of the country's cash reserves. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.